Verse 26 says that people will try to seduce you, but verse 27 says, the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you, and ye need not that any man teach you. But as the same anointing teacheth you of all things, and is truth, and is no lie, and even as it hath taught you, ye shall abide in him. He's just restating what he's already said down in verse 20. Ye have an unction from the Holy One, and ye know all things. The words unction and anointing are both from the Greek word chrisma, from which we get the word Christ, and the anointed one. And what is it exactly that we are anointed with? Acts 10:38 says that God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost. And then later in this same book, 1 John 4:13, he says that God hath given us of his Spirit. The same Holy Spirit that anointed Jesus now anoints his followers. In fact, he's called the Spirit of Christ in Romans 8:9. And he says that any man who doesn't have the Spirit of Christ is none of his. So everyone who belongs to Christ has this anointing that John's talking about here, this indwelling Holy Spirit that entered into him at the moment of his salvation. And because of this anointing, he says that Christians know all things because the anointing teacheth us of all things. Now, he doesn't mean by that that the Holy Spirit supernaturally teaches us Bible truths that we've never read or heard. But the Bible does teach those who do read and hear. He teaches us something very important about those Bible verses. He teaches us that it is truth and it is no lie. He convinces you of the reality of what the Bible says about Christ. When he first said this back in verse 20, it was in response to the Antichrist who departed because they weren't of us. And they lied about Jesus, but he said, ye have an unction from the Holy One, and ye know all things. You know all things that are true about him. The Bible basics about Christ being the sinless Son of God, who is God the Son, virgin born, crucified to pay for our sins, resurrected on the third day to raise us to new life. These are all things that every Christian knows. These are the essentials of the gospel truth that ring true with the Spirit inside of him. Lost people scratch their heads at this stuff. Virgin born, resurrected, sinless. Are you nuts? Okay, so call me crazy, but yeah, I believe God could make a virgin bear a son. Maybe I'm out of my gourd, but I believe God could live a sinless life. God could pay for the sins of the entire world. God could raise himself from the dead. In Acts 26:8, Paul asked King Agrippa a perfectly valid question. Why should it be thought a thing incredible with you that God should raise the dead? That's what God does. That's exactly the kind of thing that he does. He's God. Is there anything too hard for the Lord? And the Holy Spirit that every Christian is anointed with bears witness with his human spirit about these Bible basics. In fact, even those things that aren't immediately essential to the gospel, even things that a new believer might not have learned yet, he might not have come across it, he might not have read that far in his Bible yet, he hasn't gotten to them, but when he does hear them, the Spirit will also convince him of those things that they are true as well.